Well, today I want to carry on where we left off. And anyone who's been watching my music vlogs, I'd been invited to move into this house, 18 Earlsfield Road, which was aptly named the Mad House. And it was my mentor, Roger, who invited me to move in there. So I'll go into the details on the property. And the whole property belonged to a guy who lived in the ground floor. He was only about 18, could be 19, and tragically his parents got killed in a traffic accident, and he got left that property. Today's value, God almighty, it must be about 8 million for that. But anyway, he lived in the ground floor and he had a bit of a music connection. He was friends with one or two members of a 60s band that were quite famous, quite well known, called The Herd. And the lead guitarist out of that band went on to do other things and more fame and fortune, and that was Peter Frampton. Now, on the first floor, which he had rented out, and the second floor, on this first floor, when Michael arrived to the madhouse, there was two Americans, musicians. One called Glenn Fernando Campbell, real name Glenn Ross Campbell, who was an outstanding pedal steel guitarist. And his friend, who came over from Los Angeles with Glenn, called Steve Horde, a vocalist. Well, they had a band called The Misunderstood, and after a while I was living there, few problems developed, and eventually the band became Juicy Lucy, which I went on from the Grapefruit when they disbanded. I went to be their roadie, and then I started playing drums in the initial stages of Juicy Lucy till I got a replacement, because I was moving on to other things. But anyway, that was the first floor. Then on the top of the house, there was four of us shared the top flat, two bedroom flat. Michael lived on a put-me-up bed in the front room, along with Roger, who had his own small single bed. And the two bedrooms were allocated out to a guy called Chris, and Chris was chief roadie for Fleetwood Mac at the time. I'm going back 1969, so Peter Green was still with them before he disappeared off the planet. And in the other bedroom, this guy was as zany as the band that he worked for, but I became very good friends with him, Big Jerry. And I'll put a little music clip on now of the band he worked for. Ladies and gentlemen, the Bonzo Dog Doodah Band.
I'm the urban spaceman, baby, I've got speed. I've got everything I need. I'm the urban spaceman, baby, I can fly. I'm a supersonic guy. I don't need pleasure, I don't feel pain. If you were to knock me down, I'd just get up again. I'm the urban spaceman, baby, I'm making out. I'm all about. Place.
Yes, well, I hope you enjoy that. I'll put a vlog on just on the Bonzos at another stage. But as you can see, quite a zany outfit if you've never seen them before. Anyway, just to close this short vlog off, I want to say, once I got settled into this house, that on one occasion, going up the staircase to the top floor, I met Big Jury coming down. And he said to me, "Oh, Mark," he says, "I'm going, you fancy going to a party Saturday night if the band's got nothing doing?" I said, "Yeah, yeah, the band's in studio, so I'll not be around late." So, yeah. Yeah, he said, "Well, 8 o'clock Saturday night, I'll meet you, I'll see you in the flat, and we'll go off to a party. You might like where we're going." I said, "Where to?" He said, "I'm not going to tell you. You'll find out." Well, I did find out on that Saturday. And as we jumped into the Bonzo's old Humber Hawk car to go to this party, we picked up Vivian on the way. Vivian Stanchel, the lead vocalist from the Bonzo, who asked who I was, to which Big Jury replied, "An up-and-coming percussionist." And to which Vivian said, "Well, you'll enjoy where we're going tonight then, won't you?" And I said, "Oh, will I? Oh, hasn't Jerry told you where we're going?" I said, "No." He said, "We're going to Keith Moon's house." And that's the next vlog. Something to worth watching. Okay, bye for now.